It's Christmas like a mug in here. It's your boy, Tommy Mars. I know this week I had like a whole bunch of videos planned, but when I said that, I forgot it was Christmas week. So guess what I've been doing all week? Holiday episodes. So I am back today because the other day for my lovely patrons, I put up my first watch. I didn't even know that Taylor Swift had a Christmas song, Christmas Tree Farm. I didn't even know it existed. So then I said, oh, there's a video. So then I watched the video and I was like, wow, this is a really good video. I love all the footage, the camcorder. It was so nicely put together. But the other thing was, I thought the song was just ridiculous, like so good. I questioned in that video and I got a few DMs and stuff about it. And I was saying, well, how is this not everywhere? How is Christmas Tree Farm not on every station? I'm a big like Christmas music fan. Like I like the Mariah Carey tune. I like the Pentatonix stuff. I like the standards. I like Do They Know It's Christmas? Wham! You know, Last Christmas and stuff. But I never heard that song until just the other day when I watched the video. And son of a gun, I've listened to it a couple times since. It is a great song. It should be on every list of Christmas music. I thought it's so sweet. So today, and this was not planned. Actually, I got a couple messages to say, hey, you should do the live version for YouTube since you already gave us this version. I was like, oh, yeah, that sounds like a good idea. So that's what I'm doing today, folks. We are watching Taylor Swift Christmas Tree Farm live at Capitol's Jingle Bell Ball 2019. Right? This is going to be so much fun. Now that I know the song, I'm so excited to see her perform this live. And I get to hear another version of it, which, you know, never a bad thing, right? All right, let's go. She's like, hey. Hey, Santa hat. Taylor and I are the same. We're like the same person. Nice. Oh, I saw that the video behind her. That note right there, it's so great. So catchy. I mean, it is so friggin' catchy, man. This is a great bridge, a great arc of the song. Yeah. Oh, that's, oh man. I don't think she's ever looked better in my eyes. I thought she looked so good there. The white outfit, her skin was glowing, her hair looked great. She just looked so, I don't even know what the word is, healthy. I don't even know what the word is, but she just looked so great. That big smile and stuff, man, I swear, I don't know if I've ever seen her look better than that. That was such a great performance. Everything about that. Next year, that is absolutely going on my Christmas playlist. That is such a, I'm going to get an early start though, because I always have a few that I put on there, and that is such a good one. And I don't even mean just for like a holiday single or a Christmas single. I mean, it's just a great song. Those do, 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 you know, those high ones that she does. It's such a creative songwriting element right there, because it's those things that you wait for when you listen to a song. You know, it's all the thing when you're putting together a song. And everything about it, there's a note change and that I really love, that just like, it's like the songwriter part of me that I just can't get enough of. And man, oh man, she just, girl knows how to put together a song. And those bridges, jeez, man, queen of bridges. You ain't lying. Performance-wise, I just thought it was so good. I like that she was singing the verses there live in the choruses. I know that she had backup singers, but I'm almost willing to bet the beats per minute are exactly the same as the song, only because it felt like those were her harmonies when she was hitting the chorus. So, I mean, that's just what you do when you have a big chorus like that. You have those play, and then you sing atop of those. But the verses were definitely all her there. And I thought they sounded great. Yeah, I know she had trouble a couple times. I think it was that earpiece. And that happens. I've had that happen to me too, where I've been on stage and like something was too loud, like my voice was too loud or something. And I just like kind of took it out because it was like I was getting too much of me. So, and then sometimes, you know, you kind of will look at the front of house guy or whatever, and you'd be like, you know, like I got too much me or I got too much him, you know, like he's blowing me out over here in my ears. So that happened. So I don't know if it was, I'm not really sure what the scoop was on that. But obviously she had a problem a couple times with the earpiece. But overall, man, what a great performance. I just love the smile on her face, the smile she brings to everybody else's face. Just seeing like the people in the audience, there was a couple girls dancing. You could tell they knew every word. You know, that's the thing about this. Some people are like, bah, humbug. I don't like Christmas music or whatever. I like Christmas music. It puts me in a really good mood. And this is one of those songs. You know, every time All I Want for Christmas, Mariah Carey comes on, I just get in a good mood. The same thing with the Pentatonix stuff, actually. I got all their CDs, and I listen to the Christmas music probably the most of all the Pentatonix stuff, and I just love it. And then even with the old standard stuff, I hear, you know, Jingle Bell Rock, and, you know, It's a Holiday Jolly. I like all of it. Just like all of it. So I guess I'm a Christmas geek. All right, I'm going to get out of here because I'm going to do some more Christmas episodes this week, man. I'm having a lot of fun doing this. So if you got something you want to see, I mean, this is Wednesday. I might keep filming today. Maybe I'll film something tomorrow or something. I don't know if I want to do any Christmas holiday episodes after the 25th, but I don't know. Maybe I could be talked into something this weekend. But if you got something you really burn in, you want to hear, just drop me a comment below or something. I don't know. We'll see. All right. It's Tommy Mars. I'm wishing you and yours the happiest of holidays. I hope you guys are staying safe and healthy. I will see you soon. Merry Christmas.